Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team. Today we're going to take a look into a few tips and tricks you can use the next time you are working with PMI. PMI, or product manufacturing information, is an essential component of technical documentation that provides detailed specifications, tolerances, materials, surface finishes, and other critical manufacturing requirements needed to properly produce a part or product. PMI ensures that manufacturers have all the necessary information to create components exactly as designed, maintaining quality and consistency across production runs while reducing errors and misinterpretations in the manufacturing process. Let's go ahead and get started. To begin, we're kicking things off with this cover plate. Oftentimes, the easy place to go to add PMI is the dimension or annotation groups found in the upper left of our screen. However, another tool that's often more efficient to use is the MBD logical rules, which can be found in the reuse library. These rules are crucial to establishing consistency across designs. We can choose from folders such as dimensions, feature control frames, and datums to find specific rules that meet our product needs. To apply a new rule to our part, we can just double-click on the rule and follow the prompts that are provided in the command window after. This is a great way to save time while reducing errors in manufacturing documentation. Moving along, if we switch over to our next part, we can now see what a model looks like when it's nearly finished with adding PMI. We just have one more feature control frame left to add. A feature control frame is a PMI annotation tool used to define geometric tolerances in 3D models. If we select the command from the annotation group, we are first prompted to select our location. We can choose from a number of planes, and after that, select a terminating object for our leader line to extend to. To set up the values contained in our feature control frame, we can navigate to the top of our screen. Here, we are able to set our characteristics, tolerances, and datum references. Once all is set, we can select OK and finish. Finally, let's examine the PMI note pinned to the top left of our display window. You'll notice that this note maintains its parallel position to our screen, keeping its size and location constant, even as we manipulate the model. To customize this behavior or apply it to your own PMI notes, simply right-click the note and select Settings. There, you'll find two checkboxes that control the note's orientation. One particularly useful feature of locking the size and position is the ability to freely drag the note whenever it obstructs your view. This flexibility allows you to easily reposition the note while continuing to explore different aspects of the model. In conclusion, in this video, we've reviewed a few different tricks to help us when we're working with product manufacturing information. To start, we looked at the reuse library, specifically into MBD rules. After that, we explored the feature control frame command and how we could efficiently select proper display planes and set up our tolerance values. And finally, we wrap things up by looking at orientation settings that can keep our PMI notes parallel to plane and locked in size and position. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.